Hey Team Shuckle, what is going on? Welcome back to another episode of A Double Trouble. Today we're going to do Battle Spot simply because, you know, yesterday I didn't get a really good chance to actually record this episode. So now it is today when the episode should be coming out, so just decided, you know, hey, instead of waiting around for someone, I'm just going to hop onto Battle Spot. We'll get a good battle real quick, and then we'll return right back to VGC, best 2 out of 3. So this is the team that we had before we moved on to VGC, and it had Mawile over Druddigon, but then we had the double loss, and, you know, the original plan was to switch out Druddigon for Mawile, or switch out Mawile for Druddigon, but I ended up getting the stream battles and stuff like that, so here's the team. I haven't really played with this one in a while. I'm going to hit challenge. We're at 1671. I'm sure we're going to start dropping a little bit more because we haven't really been playing that often. But yeah, I mean, this team is cool. I like it. I should be using this team more often once Lithia League starts, because this is the team that I'm going to be using for that. And yeah, so you'll see some live battles of that, hopefully. So let's think. This guy is bringing Carbink, Chansey, which is going to be quite annoying to beat, although I do have Druddigon for that. Hitmontop, Suicune, Gengar, and Sableye. So it's best, it's bring four. So I'm actually, you know, I'm really considering just bringing Druddigon and either Reunculus or Audino. But judging by the fact that he has so many things that hit both of those super effect, I'm gonna go with Druddigon and Audino. I'll be quite honest with you, I like that. I like that lead. And then I think Camerupt is gonna be pretty useful here, and Tangrowth, right? Yeah, I think those two are gonna be pretty useful. Tangrowth mainly for Hitmontop and Chansey, just in case, you know, Druddigon doesn't do much, and Camerupt for Gengar, Sableye, and Carbink. So I found this Druddigon. I got this Druddigon through Terralution 23, and you know, I tried to use an EV spread from Nugget Bridge, but it just wasn't great. His EV spread, it had life, it had what was it? Rocky Helmet and Rough Skin. And it was supposed to, you know, counter Kangaskhan pretty well, but the issue that I had with it was that it 2-hit KO'd Kangaskhan, yet it got 2-hit KO'd back, and it's slower. So, you know, the more I thought about it, the more it didn't really make sense. So, I changed up I didn't change them up, I just ended up keeping the EV spread here, but now I 1-hit KO back. And they 2-hit KO me, and that's both Garchomp and Mega Kangaskhan. So, yeah. So this thing is definitely gonna like try and burn me or go for Dazzling Gleam. So I'm just gonna bring in Camerupt. But judging by how fast this thing is, I actually really don't have any reason to attack it or go for Trick Room. So I'm gonna actually Simple Beam the Sableye and hope it's not a boosting Sableye. It's probably gonna taunt me. Oh no, it's gonna Will-O-Wisp. Okay, cool. And we're gonna get the Simple Beam off. I was thinking, yeah, it was probably gonna burn me and go for like a Dazzling Gleam. But now we got rid of its Prankster, so it's sort of useless, and that's why I like this. He actually goes for Trick Room himself, which his team was actually a lot faster than mine, so that's sort of interesting. I'm gonna go for Heat Wave because I'm sure this Carbink really has nothing for me. And I'm going to go for Helping Hand on the Camerupt. Now, the Carbink is going to be faster than me. But, again, you know, they don't really have good attacks. They're pretty much the Shuckle of the 6th gen. So, I'm not really, you know, too worried about it at all. To be quite honest with you. He does bring in Chansey, which is not great. But let's see how much this Heat Wave does. This Heat Wave does nothing. This Heat Wave does literally nothing. And you're going to go for... Oh, Jesus. Oh, my Lord. Oh, that's game. That's game. Alright, well, I can at least kill the Carbink with an Earth Power. And Chansey. What does Chansey have? I'm going to go for Trick Room. get rid of it so these things don't, like, outspeed me. Although I'm faster than Carbink, I didn't realize that, actually, from the last turn. I should not have gone for Trick Room then. That is really stupid. Oh, well. Oh, well. I don't really know what... I guess it does get Seismic Toss. Oh, hello! Okay. Well. Well. I don't know why I went for Trick Room. I don't really know how I'm slower than that Carbink. That part I don't understand. But in comes Sableye, who I'm gonna Simple Beam yet again. Also, you know what? Nah, I'm just gonna go for Earth Power, and I'm gonna Helping Hand boost it. That's all I really care about. I just want to get rid of the Sableye, to be quite honest with you. I know this. Oh right, Fake Out. I forget this thing gets Fake Out. Yeah, it's just gonna keep going for Minimize. I don't have anything to hit it, so this is gonna be one of those battles, unfortunately. But if I can at least get rid of this Sableye, you know, I tried. You know, I need to get rid of the Sableye so I can bring in my Druddigon to pretty much kill it instantly. So you're gonna go for Psych Up. Oh my lord. At least he doesn't get the guard split, right? At least he doesn't get the guard split. I think. God, if I know. Yeah, of course. Of course. And now I can't Simple Beam that thing because we all know how that's gonna end. Who do I have in the back? I've got Druddigon and Tangrowth. He doesn't have KOing power, so that's the sort of... That's the thing about his team. He really doesn't have too many ways to actually take me out. He's gonna go for Will-O-Wisp. I'm gonna avoid. That's kind of nice. He's gonna go for Substitute. I honestly don't think I have any way to take out this Chansey. That's ridiculously broken right there. But I have to keep going for this because I have to kill the Sableye. And I don't want to switch in, obviously, on that. So, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to Simple Beam it. This way it can't, you know, priority burn anything else. And I can probably outspeed it and get a superpower off or something like that. And he avoided the attack. I thought status moves can't be avoided, like Simple Beam. What? Oh, this is happening. This is happening. Oh my god, this is happening. This is happening. This is happening. I'm not happy. This is what I am living for. I'm gonna try and Simple Beam him again. And he's gonna continue to Psych Up. What a jerk. Can we hit him? We don't hit him. We're not gonna hit him with Earth Power either. I'm pretty sure this is... I mean... what the heck? Okay, we actually do hit him. Okay, that's good. But now he has priority recover, right? Okay, so... Oh, jeez. That's not good. I have an idea, but I'm not really happy about this. I'm gonna go for Trick Room and Protect with Camera Up because Seismic Toss will kill me, and obviously, you know, this Chansey is faster than me. So this way... Oh no, I have Mental Herb. I have Mental Herb. That's fine. That's fine. What? Where's my Mental Herb? I'm thinking of a different Pokemon, aren't I? Yeah, I'm thinking of Meowstic. God damn it. Okay, well, this is stupid. What did I just click? I didn't even click anything. Oh, I have to go for Struggle. Yeah. Yep. Hey, at least it doesn't miss. This is stupid. Alright, I have Citrus Berry. I forgot about the Citrus Berry. That was a stupid... Well, I mean, come on, did I really think he was going to have Taunt on this thing? Probably, yeah, that would make much sense. Yeah, I hate these teams, like, seriously. It's so broken. What are my options for Minimize? Stomp, Steamroller. Yeah, okay, like, I'm going to run those on my team. That's stupid. What do I do? Do I lock myself into Dragon Claw or do I lock myself into Superpower? Dragon Claw, that's for sure. Dragon Claw onto the Chansey. It's not going to do very much. And I can't do anything with my Audino, so I'm actually just going to... You know what? I'm actually going to keep my Audino in because I think Struggle can't miss. So that's actually not that bad of an idea. I'll dig it. I'll take it. Jutgun's huge in this game. And I do have Choice Band, so it's still going to be, you know, pretty powerful. That's not going to break that sub in the least bit, right? Nope. Wow, recoil does a lot. Okay, and you're probably going to kill my Audino here. Actually, I'm probably going to live by two. Oh, yeah. Nah, I mean, Seismic Toss does based on level, so it's pretty easy to guess. That wasn't magic. That was just good luck. Or just observation. And of course I miss. So now I'm going to bring in Tangrowth, who, of course, doesn't really have anything to hit this Sableye super effectively or with a good base power, but we're going to try. I'm going to Dragon Claw because I'm locked in. And I'm going to go for... Ooh, knockoff is a good idea. I'm going to go for knockoff. It's neutral. And you're going to burn me. Oh, I'm going to avoid. How do you like them apples? How do you like them apples? Oh, man. That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. This team is such a jerk team. It's so stupid. It's so stupid. I hate it. I probably should have killed that, I figured in my mind that obviously Sableye is the bigger threat, right? You know, because Sableye has burn, it has swagger, it has taunt. It can do a lot to me. So, of course, in my mind, I am gonna go for the Sableye first when the Carbink, I really don't know what Carbinks do. And then the Chansey, and I've been hearing a lot about these Chanseys. Then, even if it didn't have minimize, it'd be really difficult to take down. This is really frustrating, but I'm not giving up because outside of Seismic Toss, he doesn't really have good damage output. Now, I'm eventually going to die, but if I say get a crit or something like that, you know, I'm in a good position. This Sableye clearly doesn't have recover, so, you know, I'm not going to give up just because it's annoying. I'm going to keep going because there is a chance I can beat this. But obviously, it's going to be very difficult. A Chansey without Minimize, with the guard split with Carbink, is going to be very difficult to take out. That is, like, probably the most broken Pokemon in the entire game. A Chansey with guard split defenses. I think guard split, like, makes it even, right? And see, he's going for taunt now. I don't have any attacks. I am Assault Vest. Like, seriously. Chansey is like, what? Base 10 defenses? So then it halves it, or it, like, meets in the middle? I don't know. It's like base 100 or something? Yeah. Yeah. That's a lot. That is a lot. A lot. Not even kidding here. But he's not even bothering with the Druddigon, probably because of Rough Skin. Guess. This one has Sheer Force. I was originally going to go for a Rocky Helmet. Excuse me, Rough Skin. But Sheer Force just gives it so much more power. So much more power. And I like it so much better. And you're not actually going to attack. Well, yeah, because you're going to die to burn. Ugh. That was so frustrating. It's already over. I mean, there's literally nothing I can do. Even if I break the sub of the Chansey, I somehow make a move, it's gonna outspeed me anyway. That is literally the most frustrating team. Like, okay, so obviously, you know, it takes a little bit of skill to use this, a little bit. I'm not gonna say a lot because honestly, Prankster Sableye with Psych Up is, you don't really need to think anything, you just have to do it and hope for the best. So, teams like that, it's just, to me, they take the fun out of the team, out of the game. Like, what's the point, you know? You're just making it so your opponent will basically just forfeit. And, you know, someone like me who, you know, there is a good chance that I can beat it because clearly, you know, that team, the team is well put together for what it needs to be, you know? I honestly think that kind of Chansey is going to be slightly ridiculously hard to beat. You know, the guard split thing, cool. I like that. You know, that's actually pretty cool, and it's pretty clever. And because you're using a carbink, it does take some skill to, you know, set up. Carbink obviously died really easily to that earth power. Granted, it was helping hand boost it, but it's still an earth power stab off of something that has good special attack. So that part, cool. You know, that I would have, that would have been a challenge to beat that Chansey. That it would have been very, it would have been a good testament to see if Dredagon's really good, you know? Superpower, Choice Bandit, Max Attack, Brave Nature. That would have been great, you know? I would have been able to see, okay, this is the damage I put out. That is great. I am so powerful. But then you start spamming Minimize. And, you know, you just got to put yourself into their shoes and think, did you really need Minimize? You have the most broken Chansey already. You don't need the Minimize. You have Soft Boiled, I think. Or Wish. Either way, you have a way to heal yourself up. You have a way to guarantee 50 damage to your opponent every single turn. You have status. Do you really need Minimize? What does that do for you other than make your opponent frustrated? It does nothing. You don't need it with that Chansey. You really, really don't. And then to bring in the Sableye and go for Psych Up? What are you doing to me? You know? Oh, well. Alright, so Talonflame, Aegislash, Abomasnow, Garchomp, Rotom Wash, and Cresselia. Interesting to bring, Abomasnow. You don't really have anything that avoids the hail damage. Now, obviously, something can have safety goggles. That is very true. I'm thinking Reunculus Camerupt. That should be a good lead for me. I think that's a lead that I want to start off with. I think Tangrowth is going to be useful, but, you know, that Talonflame does really... The Talonflame and the Abomasnow do scare me. I'm going to bring Clefable instead. From what I've learned, Clefable actually does handle Talonflame pretty well. Talonflame only does about 30% to it, I think. So, yeah. And, you know what? I'm going to bring Dredagon. I really want to test this thing out. I really want to get it going, and especially after that last battle where I had such a perfect thing to test it out against, but then I had to not hit any of its moves. That was frustrating. That was frustrating. I just don't understand. It was fine up until the whatchamacallit. Whatever they were. The Minimize. You know, and people argue, like, hey, you know, why don't you use Aerial Ace? Or why don't you use Body Slam? Or why don't you use Stomp? Because most of those moves are pretty garbage outside of Minimize. And not that many people run Minimize. So it's like saying... It's just such a stupid way to argue that, you know? Why am I running a move that clearly doesn't help me? You know? It only helps me in a singular situation. That's pretty stupid. You know, Aura Sphere, I'll give you Aura Sphere. Aura Sphere is a good move. But still, I mean, Stomp? Really? You can ask me to use Stomp? Alright, I don't like this in here, but I'm gonna go for Trick Room. And I'm gonna go for Heat Wave. I'm hoping the, Ooh, that's scary. Oh, but if you don't kill my Camerupt, you're pretty much dead. And I think you're going for the Reunculus. No, you're going for the Camerupt. Do I survive that? I survive that, but I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die, but still, that is impressive. Helping hand boosted Shadow Ball. All I have is 252 HP. I like that. I'm gonna die to Life Orb, but that was brilliant. I loved that. That was so cool. Ah, that was awesome. I brought Dredagon, right? And I brought Clefable. Do I bring in Clefable or do I bring Dredagon? Who do I bring in? Dredagon can easily wipe the floor with this Cresselia, but you know what? I'm gonna bring in Clefable because I do have Trick Room up now, and that will give me ample opportunity to set up. And in comes Abomasnow. I like Abomasnow here. I don't Well, actually, I won't take hail damage from either of my two Pokemon. Fantastic. I'm going to Focus Blast the Abomasnow, and I'm going to start setting up my Cosmic Powers. Now, I know he has Blizzard, so Follow Me is not going to really do very well, but honestly, unless it Megas, which it probably will, it is going to Mega, okay. Now it has good offensive output, but since it's going to be a spread move, I think I should be able to handle it. Nah, you are going to go for Helping Hand, that is true. But I do land the Focus Blast, so that's good. And I am currently slower. Ooh. Ooh. Oh! Oh, Special Defense. Okay, never mind. I thought that was a special... I forgot this was a moment. What? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. A crit? Really? Really? A crit? But now I obviously can't go for Psychic. Because Psychic will, Focus Blast, because that would, end up being my undoing. But the question is, do I lock myself into Crunch, because I don't remember what his team was, or Dragon Claw, because again, I don't remember what his team was. Either way, you know, this doesn't really like dealing with fairies, but I do have Ryunculus for that. I don't think he had a fairy. I don't think he did. I'm gonna lock myself into Dragon Claw. It's Stab, it should do good. Abomasnow goes for Protect, interesting. Yeah, you probably have Moonblast, so Crunch probably was a better idea. Although, you know, that does do good damage. He is actually going to Psychic the Druddigon, not Moonblast, so oh, that was a crit. Wow, that was bulkier than I thought it would be. The question is, do I outspeed this thing or do I not? If I outspeed, that's good, and I'll kill it. I should outspeed it. I am a Ryunculus, but, you know, Mega Abomasnow is fairly slow, it's a toss-up. If I don't, I lose. If I do, I don't know if I win yet. Don't know. But Psychic should definitely kill it, because especially with the special defense drop, even without it. No, he's going to go for Ice Shard. Okay. Onto Ryunculus. I survived that. Oh my god, I survived that. That was awesome. He probably has, like, no attack investment whatsoever. That was beautiful. Oh my god, that was so beautiful. I am so happy about that. That was amazing. Oh man, that was amazing. I survived that at 7 HP, and because of Magic Guard. Trick Room's still up, right? Trick Room is still up. I think... that's game, unless he has Citrus. If he has Citrus, that's game. That's maybe not game. Oh, no, he's going to Protect. Okay, he's going to try and stall it out. Oh, my God. Please tell me I have at least one more turn. One more turn. One more turn. Come on. Come on. One more turn. One more turn. I need one more turn. One more turn. You're probably protected, forgetting about... oh, damn. Forgetting about, Magic Guard? No, he definitely protected to stall out the Trick Room. So he's gonna go for Thunderbolt onto the Ryunculus, that makes the most sense. Although, I could probably take a Thunderbolt from it at my current HP. Let's see how much Dragon Claw does. Whoa! And the hail stops. Okay, you don't have Citrus Berry. You have leftovers. So if I survive a Thunderbolt 8 or a Hydro Pump, which I resist both. Ooh, let's see. This is a really good test for Druddigon. This is a really good test. So he's going to go for Hydro Pump. Can I survive this? Oh, Lord. I love this Druddigon. This is so good. We get a crit on top of that. Not that it really mattered at all, but that was actually really nice. Druddigon is power. Druddigon, wow. Okay, I'll take it. I'll take it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Comment down below what you think about that Blissey strategy. And if you really do think it takes skill or, you know, what, and just don't just say, you know, hey, it takes skill, you're stupid. Give a reason. Yeah, talk it out. Let's have a discussion. So thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it, and I hope to see you guys at the next video.